Every one of us should guard the other. The wife is supposed to compass her husband. Mm-hmm. The husband is supposed to cleave to the wife so that one, the two of them can become one flesh. And we looked at this from the start and we say now, the couple is expected to be transparent. There's no barrier between the two of you.
Yeah.
But there are rules governing this game. And every time you break this rule, you will find yourself on the wrong side. And it will not treat you fairly.
Mm-hmm.
There are so many couples who have been treated unfairly by marriage. Marriage is very delicate, very sweet, but very delicate.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Simply when you just cross to the wrong side, it easily reacts against you. And finally, you find yourself crying, find yourself, you are not where you are supposed to be.
Mm-hmm.
So there is what is supposed to happen between the two of you.
Yeah.
You are supposed to cleave and then become one flesh. The wife is supposed to compass and protect that husband, compassing, being together with that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this makes you being able to work together as a family. And therefore, you are supposed to do things that will make you come together. Anything that is keeping you apart, you are not supposed to entertain it in marriage. Anything that is keeping you apart, you are not supposed to entertain it. In Genesis 2:25, we understand that the man and the woman were naked and they were not ashamed.
Yeah.
So the two of them were very transparent. Nakedness is transparency. That you can understand one another. There's no secret between me and my wife. You are not supposed to have any secret between the two of you. Even when you are engaged, a person begins now to hide things away from you. They don't trust you with information. Some people in love, you easily forget and ask, what was I telling? Even before I knew you,
mm-hmm.
the first day we met, I started telling you my things. Even I had not proposed and say, this is the woman.
Yeah.
But I started telling you and I went and asked myself, how could I be so open to this stranger, but I don't know this stranger, but I started speaking. You knew in your heart because God had also revealed you, but he had not revealed to me. So you understand that, hey, this is coming, and this is what the man is. And now, I want you to understand this. You are supposed also to understand that privacy in marriage does not exist between the couples. But the two of you need to guard your privacy. The two of you need to guard your privacy. There are things I can say to my wife, I cannot say to any other woman. There are some things my wife can say to me and cannot say to any other woman. Now, for us now to be together and to be able to work together as a couple, we agree that there are things we do for us to cleave. We said the woman, the Bible says, the man shall leave his father and mother. That's 24.
Yeah.
And shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become
one
flesh. So there's living and cleaving.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't live, you can't cleave. And if you can't cleave, you can't be one flesh.
Yeah.
And if you can't be one flesh, there shall be quarrels, differences mm-hmm. in that marriage. People quarreling because of differences. There are differences, they don't agree. They can't agree. And this is what brings friction in that marriage.
But some people have taken it's normal. It's normal to quarrel. Every marriage has...
No.
That's,
it's not
that's a slogan that is keeping many on the side of problem.
Hear us. It is not normal for you to quarrel. Quarrels is not normal. There are some people who can have an issue. She can have a different opinion,
mm-hmm.
but we can solve it without quarreling. I'm talking about quarreling. You understand what is quarreling?
Yeah.
So you can have a debate, an healthy debate between a couple.
Mm-hmm.
And you can discuss and say, this is the way forward. Sometimes, as we operate in another level, we are able to understand each other's minds. And she is able to understand my needs quickly. And I am able to understand her. But sometimes, there are an issue that comes and we have to discuss.
Mm-hmm.
And when we discuss, it's debate. She has to give her point, I have to give my point. And then finally we say, this issue needs this direction.
Mm-hmm.
As a man, there sometimes I use authority as a man and say, this requires direction.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the direction that we are going to follow. In this case,
mm-hmm.
we are going to follow this direction. Mm-hmm. And she says, yes. And when we follow, say, so you are right. You are right.
Yeah.
Because this is what our it needed. Because a man, we say, you must stay in the presence of the Lord
mm-hmm.
for you to know the secrets. You are supposed to know the secret from God. So you stay in the presence of God more so that you know. Adam was more experienced than Eve. Because he came first. He learned about that. I don't say that a woman cannot know more than a man. It's possible. I say that. But man, you need to be understand that you are the leader. Responsibility lies on you. And the woman comes to ask. When the woman asks, what are you thinking? Don't ask her or don't tell her it's the same way you are thinking. No, she is looking for opinion. And she will work with your opinion to produce the best out of that opinion. That's why you are a father. The woman came out of you. He came out of you. And all the children, they are coming out of you. So you are the father. You are the leader. So you have to give the direction as you as a leader. And it's possible.
Amen.
It's possible you can be wrong also. Don't elevate yourself to the point that you feel that a man cannot make a mistake. A man can make a mistake. It's only God who cannot make a mistake. And sometimes when you make a mistake, you need to be humble enough to come and say, sorry. It takes humility for transparency to exist between a couple. It takes humility for transparency to exist between a couple. If there is no humility, then the couple will not have transparency between the two of them. And therefore, it will be difficult for this relationship to move on. So we said this.
Mm-hmm.
This couple, for you to cleave, they are thinking right away, even before marriage.
Yes.
You're supposed to leave.
Mm.
A man shall leave his father and mother and cleave to the wife and become one flesh. So the direction is very clear. A male is the one who leaves father.
Mm-hmm.
A male leaves the father and mother because the males are difficult to be released. A woman does not leave mother and father. The woman does not leave the father. Why? She changes father. One father to another. Changes the father, biological to the father with his husband, because she came from him, the rib. She came out of the man. So the woman is looking not just to be loved. She's looking for commitment.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody will commit. She would cover her. Mm-hmm. She's looking for a covering. She's looking for a name.
Yeah.
That is why most of them, when you marry, you drop your name.
Mm-hmm.
You add the name of your,
mm-hmm.
you change from the name of your father to the name of your husband.
Yes.
That's why you change fathers
mm-hmm.
from this father to another. So the man, you understand, when you get married,
mm.
immediately you have married a father. You are married a girl, a baby,
mm.
the first baby. That's why men, you have the right to call your wife baby. Because she came out of you. So you nurture her. You take care of her. You prune her. That's why Adam was trained first to take care before Eve was brought. And then after you take care of her, you produce the best out of her. And it begins the very day you know the value of this person. That's why when Adam looked at Eve, he said, this is the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called a woman. And that's where joy began now in that marriage relationship. So that's why I tell a woman, please don't be stressful and force yourself to a man who does not know your value. A man who does not know your worth will never respect you. A man who does not know your worth will never take care of you. And you need that. That's a need in you, attached to you. The woman is not created to carry loans and burdens, so many burdens. Directly, she carries burden from the husband. It is the husband who receives it and then gives to her. She is comfortable with that. The woman is comfortable to support the family, comfortable to work, comfortable to win bread for the family, but she is not comfortable to work for a man who is not working, a man who is sleeping, and she wakes up and go and tries to do everything and then bring the bread home. That is not a man, because the devil has left and moved him from his place, and now the woman is carrying the bag. It doesn't matter how much the woman is paid or how much she earns. What the husband gives is the most important thing for a woman. It doesn't matter what the woman can buy for herself. She can buy anything for herself. But what matters to her most is what the man can buy for her. Is what this husband can buy.
She values most.
She values. And that is why it is even wise, even if she gives you something, if it's the money you have received, even if you buy that gift from that money, she will feel good. She will feel respected. I was dealing with a lady. Maybe she was watching this program. And she had done so much for the husband. The husband happened to be the pastor at that time. And she happened to be working. She was tithing in that church. Her salary. tithing in the church, and the pastor, her husband is the pastor. Number two, she had done some development. Even when she's paying the rent where she was living, because they were living at different places because of work, she would visit her husband visit. And sometimes she would fail to pay the rent intentionally, even when she has the money. She would wait for the husband to come and then take the money to the agents. So that she never wanted to be feel as I am the one sustaining myself here. And the husband would do that. She would buy a property and then write one in their name, another in the husband. She would think the husband, because she knew the husband was not earning as much as she was earning at that time. But one thing began to pain her. They started to develop the hand to school, to begin the hand at school. And the school was not, was a young one, was not doing very well at that time. And then the church. But the husband would not contribute anything to one's welfare. Now she became worried and concerned and asked her a question. Even if he came and bought something from even what I contribute myself, he is the priest in that house, and he is entitled to salary or to tithes and offerings, and he earns something from that. If he comes with a little thing and does something for the family, I will be comfortable. But he has relaxed. Yes, he is doing the work of God. Yes, he's running, but I am not getting his contribution. That's a point she was speaking. She and her concern in her heart.
Yeah.
Because the husband is not playing the role of the husband.
Or
what do you see about that?
Yeah, that is very critical. And I would wish also to advise, especially now, because if someone is in marriage,
mm-hmm.
The husband is just, he has relaxed the mm-hmm. way this man relaxed.
Mm-hmm.
I think the best thing is this woman to pray for this person, and also to talk. It is good to speak.
To pray and talk.
Talk. Yeah. Then if you're in a relationship and you see someone...
That's where I wanted you to
yes.
to advise. Because
yes.
when I talk to the ladies, I will say I am a man.
Yeah. Yeah, if you're in a relationship and someone is just sidelining you in all things, he does not want you to be involved in anything.
Mm-hmm.
He does not show his concern. When especially you're in a relationship and he's just taking you for a ride,
mm.
you should pause first and pray and hear God. Because when you're in a relationship, it's better.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's one day to the wedding, you stop.
Mm.
Rather than entering into
a marriage and have a divorce. Mm-hmm.
So when it comes to the young people,
mm.
you are just in a relationship. It's a strenuous relationship. This man is not committed. This man, he does not give out the information.
Mm.
This man is not open.
It's very secretive.
Very secretive. And mm. even when you reach out, you want to get some information.
Mm-hmm.
Either he's against or he asks you how far is this relationship
mm-hmm.
that you're digging deep. So there are some things that you can see. This is a warning. This
mm-hmm.
is a warning.
Mm-hmm.
And first of all, you either stop it or you pray until you hear God. Because there are things you will ignore. We say relationship, it's not a rehabilitation center.
Yeah.
You cannot just rehabilitate someone
mm-hmm.
to
fit your life.
Your life.
Mm-hmm.
You can't.
Mm-hmm.
The word of God is very clear. Every good and perfect gift is from the Father. It's
yeah.
from God.
Yeah.
So, and God is not the author of confusion.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes there are people who say, I don't hear God.
Mm-hmm.
I'll pray, but I don't know because I don't know how he speaks.
Mm-hmm.
But God will give you some signs,
mm-hmm.
some signals. Even when you talk with someone,
mm.
you know if you are have the same direction of life
mm.
or you are having parallel directions.
Mm-hmm.
So some signs when you see them early, know that God is just speaking a message.
Yes. And you should, there's a warning.
Yeah, there's a
for
warning.
You.
You should not ignore, because when it comes to marriage, it is a very sensitive thing.
Now, this is very, very interesting.
Yes.
There are ladies who still complain.
Mm.
This man is not committed. This man is not devoted in this. I have been doing this. I am the one. If I don't call, he cannot call. If I am the one who initiates, we shall meet. This man does not initiate anything. Then you see the same lady says, I am the one who gives gifts even to this man. He has never given me a gift. So what do you advise
about that? That's perversion already, mm. because if when it comes to marriage,
mm-hmm.
marriage does not begin the day you go to church and you are blessed as a husband and a wife.
Mm.
Marriage begins immediately during that day of proposal.
Mm.
When this person proposes to you, this is the time.
Spiritual marriage begins. Mm.
And of course, we say the physical marriage with limitations.
Mm.
How do we do the physical marriage with limitations? Your interactions, callings, things, gift, without that close intimacy mm-hmm. that will arouse your flesh. Mm. So there are limits when it comes to physical marriage. But mind marriage, spiritual marriage, this marriage should be, to, if possible, to the level of perfection, though you cannot attain it during courtship. So I'm saying this mm-hmm. that mm-hmm. If I'm in a relationship, mm-hmm. I'm the one who is calling, mm-hmm. I'm the one who is buying airtime, mm-hmm. I'm the one who is buying gift, mm-hmm. I'm the one who is initiating. Mm-hmm. We can have a date so that we can talk. Mm-hmm. There's no relationship there.
I see this, and I remind men.
Yeah.
Women will ask a lot of questions, and this irritates you. No woman would like to marry a man that she does control. Not understand.
Yeah,
she wants to understand you. That's why she will ask many questions.
Mm-hmm.
So avail those questions, answers as soon
as possible. Yeah.
Number two, understand this. The woman is not looking for a fellow woman.
Yeah.
She is looking for a male. A male is a leader. And a male is supposed to be a one taking initiative. We pursue women. We bring them on board in relationship. Then we take care of her, we lead her.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that is what it should be happening in a relationship. And then a man is supposed to lead in that relationship,
yes.
Relationship issues. The woman is not supposed to nag you every time.
Mm-hmm.
I want this in a relationship and initiate that.
Mm-hmm.
It is not supposed to be like that. A man is also supposed to lead in the things of faith. You're supposed to mm-hmm. lead in the things of faith. Mm-hmm. Not. That is why Adam was met in Eden. Eden means God's presence.
Yes.
So he was met there because he is supposed to lead in the issues of God. Then number three, in decision making, the man is supposed to lead.
Mm-hmm.
So a man is not supposed to take forever before he gives a simple instruction. Because some of us, you are given a simple instruction, you take so long before you come to a decision that is so obvious. So obvious answer is ABCD. She was just looking for a concept. That is called passivity. And when passivity comes in, it will kill that marriage. A man is supposed to take initiative. And then to the woman, I'm going to give you free advice. Free.
Mm-hmm.
For free. Take this for free. Don't make a man to be good so that he can earn favor before your people so that you marry that man. Don't buy him clothes. Don't give him
you'll
a car.
Don't,
he will never value you. Man can do that for you, but you doing for a man that way is perversion. Man is supposed to ward you and take care. Who is supposed to dress? The man. That's why he was said, till dress. We don't see those instructions given to woman in the Bible. It was given to the man.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Divine Marriage Program Online. And my name is Apostle Domitian Mwenda. We are together with my wife, Pastor Florida Mwenda. And you are encouraged to share this broadcast with your friends. Watch parties with them. And also share this information with them so that they can get the information. We are discussing about boundaries in marriage. How far should couples allow external forces to influence them? And we are saying this is something that the couple is supposed to watch and be careful how they lead their own affairs, because if they don't understand this, it will really cost them and it will be very painful in their marriage relationship. I say there's some things we discuss again that a man is the couple or the man is supposed to leave.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing, apart from leaving the father now, exchanging the fathers, is supposed to leave the close friends.
Yes.
Especially of the opposite sex.
Mm-hmm.
So the opposite sex are not supposed, especially girls or ladies who are close to you. They are not supposed to continue to be close to you when you have come into marriage. They are not supposed to be very close to you. You are supposed to leave them. You go aside and leave these people. You are not supposed to be so much connected with them or so much attached to them.
Mm.
You are not supposed to be like that. And they should not influence what you are supposed to do. So there are men who married, but they were not able to go apart.
Disconnect
themselves. Yes. From the close people who were close to them, or the couples were not able to detach from their opposite sex. And we discussed that at length. Then influence, direction, or counsel of the extended family members.
Mm-hmm.
Influence and also counsel from the extended member of the family. You are supposed to leave that influence. You are supposed to allow that influence to move away from you. Influence, and also counsel of the extended family. Then spending more time, your free time, you are spending it too much with your colleagues. And when you ask, you say, this is profession. You are spending your free time with your colleague, especially of the opposite, in the name of the work. No, you're not supposed to continue like this in a marriage relationship. Then you are supposed to have what we call the physical location. You are supposed to move physically. The physical location is supposed also to be observed, and also financial dependence. Yeah. You're not supposed to depend financially on that. So if you do that, you are supposed, you will be doing your marriage a lot of favor, a lot of favor. Now, before we continue with the rules that we send people are supposed to do, I believe you have a comment to say about that, then we can move on in the name of Jesus. Okay, so I want you to get this. There are things we said you are not supposed to allow to happen in this marriage. If you allow, you will never cleave. Mm. You will never become one flesh.
Yeah.
You allow this interference, you will never become one flesh. You allow this interference, you will not move as a system the way you are supposed to be.
Mm.
So there is something that you are supposed to understand. Now, if you put opinions now of others away from your spouse, because we have seen it to some extent, your husband, their wife, prepares you something to dress. Then a lady friend says, this is not nice. Change. And then the husband tells the wife, I cannot go with this. So and so has suggested I change. That means what is running that family is not the opinion of the wife.
Mm-hmm.
So the wife gets concerned. And when the wife gets concerned, she may ask herself, how comes that this man or this lady is the one controlling my husband? And when the husband says, the wife gives you counsel, you decide and say, I must first of all ask so and so, and say so and so is not for the idea, and this so and so is our friend. That means you value that so and so as a friend more than you value your or the opinion of your own wife, to the extent that when the wife says something, when the wife says something, you don't get it until you ask that person. And this wife feels, no, this is not my opinion. That is not my advice. She will start asking, who am I in this relationship? When the husband, also the same way, maybe tells the wife, let me do this. And the wife says, no, I will ask. I will ask so and so. So and so is a male friend. And this male friend has so much influence on your wife that the wife must ask some things even before. Even when you tell your wife, this air is good. And it goes that friend says, this air is not good. Your wife will meet you in the evening changed. And the air starts changing. You say, what happened to the air? And I told you it's nice. Say, so-and-so told me it is not nice. And so-and-so, who is this so-and-so? Friend. So when the kind of things happen, then you wonder what kind of wife do I have? Because she is being controlled by someone else, not me. Others, it may be not a friend, but a relative. If you design something, you say even building site, you say we shall build that place. Say, mom, my aunt said that is not good. The weather is very bad there, so I can't continue. Say, oh, we want another child. I shared the idea with my mom, and my mom told me it's too soon. So you ask, who is now the decider in this marriage? Am I the one deciding? Is the man deciding? Is my brother deciding? To the extent, when a wife calls to the husband and says, the husband, I need this clothes for the children. and didn't, and this is a money to do shop. That's why, because I would tell so and so to shop for them. As she comes home, she will come with them, or I will call her to accompany you for shopping so that she will show you how to shop for my children and where places where those nice things are. So the wife asked, can't I know how to shop for my children? You must involve your friend. That friend may be married or not married. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And this now becomes an issue. Then the wife, sometimes you give a friend money when you are leaving, and you tell him, go and give to my wife. And when I said to my wife, I will give some money to so and so, so that she will pass it to you, with a cousin, a sister, or a friend. And now you expect that there shall be freedom in that marriage. Okay. There is no freedom. There is no peace in that marriage. There is no joy in that marriage, because there is an intruder. The boundary is not laid.
Now, I as you're talking, I think you should help us, mm-hmm. or help some people, especially now when it comes to some of the servants of God. Because I've heard of cases,
mm-hmm.
where there are pastors, especially in church,
mm-hmm.
there are some specific ladies,
mm-hmm.
who shop for their pastor,
mm-hmm.
but they don't shop for the wife of,
mm-hmm.
the pastor.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, they go and look for designer suit,
mm-hmm.
for the man of God.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's like this man of God is torn between the SMSs,
mm-hmm.
that comes on Saturday,
mm-hmm.
from these ladies.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to put on that suit that I bought you.
Mm-hmm.
It
in Turkey.
Don't know.
In Turkey.
Mm-hmm. It just makes you stand very tall.
Mm-hmm.
When I see you that suit, oh my gosh,
mm-hmm.
oh my gosh. The day you preach wearing that suit,
mm-hmm.
You
flow. The anointing was flowing.
Mm-hmm. So the wife of the pastor will just prepare, maybe innocently prepares a certain color.
Mm-hmm.
But now, even very late,
mm-hmm.
maybe the pastor was not aware of,
mm.
what he's putting on tomorrow.
Mm.
But this SMS is now.
Mm-hmm.
He's torn in between. Or,
mm.
maybe it's one,
mm-hmm.
that has come that,
mm.
day. At very late at night.
Mm-hmm.
Now the wife, she's given information.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow I'm putting on maroon.
Mm.
This and this suit.
Mm.
And fortunately or unfortunately, the wife sees the text. So,
mm-hmm.
it is a lady who has made me,
mm-hmm.
to go back to ironing board, to iron
the clothes.
The clothes.
Now, we said this, and I want to remind our viewers that when you allow some opinions outside the marriage,
mm-hmm.
come into your marriage,
mm-hmm.
it will cause strife.
Yeah.
It will cause strife, and this strife will cause division.
Mm.
So, you shall meet yourself divided, you and your wife. You shall be divided. So there are some actions and ones that you are not supposed to allow, especially coming from the opposite sex into you when you're in marriage. For example, now, if a lady buys you a gift, you're a man of God, and she buys a gift innocently, she is not supposed to follow how you use that gift. You can decide either to dispose it, or you can decide not to use it. So You are supposed to have wisdom as a man of God. You discern, why did this person give me this gift? If this person was, the motive was evil, you are not supposed to receive. If the motive was wrong, you are not supposed even to wear that. You need to understand that, and you should not encourage that. And again, don't place the opinion of anybody who says you are smart or not above your wife. Because this will also come and cause the strife that will bring your marriage down, or,
mm-hmm.
make your marriage,
mm-hmm.
not happy.
Yeah.
So you are not supposed to do that.
Yes.
So that's something you need to guard yourself from.
Mm-hmm.
Once you are extremely beautiful, you are extremely what? Those ones that comes from person who has a wrong motive. They'll say closeness and also ones and actions. You are supposed to keep a distance. And allow yourself to be in a position that you are not going to be influenced or being directed by an opposite sex. It doesn't matter where you stand. It doesn't matter where you are. It's not matter if you're a pastor, it's a colleague in work, because
some are
controlled also with their colleagues. Because
yes.
sometimes you go shopping, they may not buy for you,
mm-hmm.
but you buy for yourself. But they saw it, say, what? Or they see you. Sometimes you came on that. Say, that one is nice. I want to see you on that. This person is trying to build an appetite in the wrong area. an appetite on the food that you will not eat. It's not yours. So you are supposed to guard that. And there's some language you are supposed to stop as a couple. There's some language you are supposed to stop between, or you should not allow to come from the other person who is not in a marriage. And there's privacy between the two of you that you are supposed to meet. If you encourage that, we say there's a man who don't want to keep a distance.
Yeah.
They want to come close and also argue.
Yeah.
Stay. Just holding you tightly and don't let to lose you. There is emotional, they are giving emotional message. Yeah, the same came to the lady.
Yes.
There is an emotional message this person is trying to communicate. Once, you are beautiful, you look this, you look like, you look this, you exaggerate. Even as a woman, it's not good, it's not bad to tell a person you are smart.
Yeah.
With a good motive, you are smart. But there is exaggeration. You see those ones are exaggerated, and you see this person has become too much. You need to feel it as a person and then keep a distance. You need to keep a distance. We a person who want to see you always. A
no,
lady want to come
dear.
to your house always. A lady want to come at your desk always at a place of work. A lady want to come always and sit together with you, even in a and lady want to take coffee with you always. And she is looking for opportunities, slightest opportunity to have that.
Some are asking, how am I going to keep to keep off? How am I going to keep a distance? Should I rebuke? Should I? Can you?
There are so many ways of keeping a distance. If your stand is known,
yes.
For example,
yeah.
we were in a place. A man, a lady comes. She wants to go all over this man in the name of taking a photo.
Yeah.
This man starts to say, no, I don't want to hold you. I don't want to appear like I'm holding other man's wife, and that is against my principle. So
must
have a stand. You must have put a boundary.
Yes.
And this is a stand. Let them know who you are and who you live for.
Yes.
So when they understand who you are and your principles, you speak openly your principles. You speak what you like and what you don't like. So if you entertain it, because these people will not start by arguing you. They start. Today, you move from this inch, moving to another inch.
To test the depth of the waters. Yeah.
So when you see the place is free,
yeah,
you
they,
move.
They just...
So you must put guns yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You must not allow some things. Old lady to comment some things, even you. Some similar say, I'm in my message today. And it's taking to
some
you.
Of them, they will even take a funny photo. And they will send you. Some
so
will
you
send
need you, to rebuke.
Some will send you a photo. They are naked. They have just taken a selfie and they sent you to see how you will react. If you keep quiet, they know this man.
Or you like say
smart.
Gorgeous.
They know this,
they person
know this is penetratable. So she will do something else that is even more worse. But if you say this is wrong, I can't entertain this, you should know I am a married man or I am a married woman, they will fear. They will not bring the
say respect your own marriage, honor
first.
Your own marriage by keeping those distance, because if that is why you need to declare, why do I have the ring? It's because I'm married. So let everybody know where I go. I'm married and I love my wife and they love my children, and you show that respect. You respect others and others will end respecting you. But when you see there's some characters or some qualities of people who do not have boundaries.
Yeah.
You need to show them there is a boundary here. Because if you don't do this, you are going to keep on inviting unnecessary battles. Who do you value? Your marriage or something else? So you keep on inviting unnecessary battles. Strife. And this strife will bring separation in that marriage.
So speaking your mind, speaking your stand. Because as I'm not saying even your mind.
Is stand.
Your
declaring.
Stand. Declaring your
you
stand.
You declare your stand.
Yeah.
Let them know who you live for.
So if someone, even in your, maybe this person is having your number, she can send a message either through Messenger, through WhatsApp, you should be known what you live for.
Yeah.
Because there are people who will share anything, any rubbish they'll find out there, they can just forward to test. If this
sometimes you need to declare your stand. Intentionally.
Yes.
Intentionally. And sometimes you declare your stand anyhow because you don't know where the bullet will come from. So it should be your habit.
Yes.
And then now, if you have friends, for example, you have friends of the opposite sex, family, those who come, family, friends. Why should a man visit my wife when I'm not there?
And it becomes...
I'm a pastor, yes. Mm-hmm. Why should my elder, a senior elder or assistant pastor, keep on coming to my house
mm-hmm.
when I am not there?
Mm-hmm.
To my wife alone and there are other elders in the church?
Mm-hmm.
Why should I, pastor, keep on visiting my cheerleader alone and keep on going that home alone? Every time my car is being seen parked somewhere, they're in a family alone. Why should I be visiting these female colleagues alone? Why should a female colleague visit you? And some people do it as a, like a trap.
Mm.
Say, I will introduce you to my wife. And I've seen them do that.
Mm-hmm.
I will introduce you to my wife. You become friends so that we can cover up.
Yeah.
So anytime you come, my wife will understand that you are not coming for me, but you check on me. And this can, sometimes can they can come and meet you and declare, I was coming to your wife. And they know because they are caught.
They are but cheating, of course.
And I tried to call her. Her number is not going through. So pretending it is just a coincidence. And they try to build a relationship between the two.
Mm-hmm.
And then you entertain. You welcome. Welcome. We can wait for my wife. She sit down. You try to do something waiting. Maybe she knows nobody's around. The children are in school. And you are the two of you. And finally, she will continue doing that until you... That board is broken, yeah, the barrier.
Yeah,
going to break the barrier.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally you meet yourself. Hey, you are in a place where there is no control, there is no limit. And we need to understand that is where the enemy will try to work through and begin to break the marriage and bring us to the place where we would not like to be. So we are supposed to stop such things. Now, we are supposed to stop even some jokes.